Hello, my name is Steve Hawks and welcome to my first Pyrography video. And I figured we'd get out the old 25 watt single temp burner today. You can get this just about anywhere. The spoon shader is my favorite tip of the bunch. I did do some modifications to it. I'm going to show you that right now. The problem I was having was the tip, the pointy end, was getting stuck in the wood and it was making marks that I didn't want there. I wanted a more smooth surface. So what I did was I grabbed a pair of pliers and just bent the tip up a little bit. And that solved my problem. It does lower the surface area a little bit, but it solved my problem in getting the dark spots that I didn't want. Now these are sanding sheets. They come a little larger than this. I cut them down into smaller squares. They work great for removing the carbon and all the residue that builds up on the tips. And it doesn't harm the tip itself. They come in fine, medium, and coarse. You definitely want to get the fine. It won't scar your tip. I like to screw them in by hand, that way I don't over tighten the tip. This actually has an on-off switch, so we'll turn it on and we'll wait 10 minutes and we'll be right back. Alright, now we're going to be doing some sketching later on. We're going to be doing some grasses. So I'm just using, you know, the flat part of the tip. I can use the side to create branches and twigs. And I can slow it down a little bit and use the bottom edge, almost where it's rounded off and bent. And you know, the slower you pull it, the darker the value is going to be. And as much as it may look like I meant to put in every branch and it's catching all sorts of light, and you know, these things happen by accident. You know, when you're using the right stroke, all sorts of good things happen. Here I'm using just little circles. And these little circles look like groups of leaves. You know, I'm really not trying to be too detailed. And when we get to the grasses, you know, a little bit of variety. It's an up and down stroke. Use the side, create some thinner and darker blades of grass, some shadows. Can pull up some grass. So here it's a combination of zigzags and up and downs and little circles. So I'm just working in tiny circles here. I try not to spend too much time in any one area. I do like to put the darker values in first. It just helps you be a little bit more brave with the pen. And also, when you lift your pen off the wood, it reheats. And those darker areas are a great way to bring the pen down and hide those initial marks that you get. And that's how I get the middle values and the lighter values that you see here. And I'm just putting in a couple other shapes and, you know, just things that look like leaves and groups of leaves. A few years ago, I picked this pen up at a local store, and you know, my goal was just to do some damage to some old wooden crates and wooden things we had around the house. just to see what I could do. And you know, it was frustrating at first. You know, the main thing you'll notice when you first start wood burning is you get divots. You get marks at the end of your stroke. The key, if you don't want to damage the wood, is just to keep the pen moving fast. You can't really see it in the video, but I blow on the tip to cool it down. You can even try keeping a fan next to you to keep the tip a little bit cooler while you're working. You know, I like doing sketches like this because it really frees you up. You know, you're not worried about any details. And I've got some other surfaces that I like to use, especially when sketching like this. So make sure to stay tuned at the end of the video. I'm going to show you a cheap alternative to using wood. And I guarantee you've got some around the house. You know, I'm turning the pen side to side. You know, I just cooled the pen down in that grassy area, and that allowed me to jump quickly into the background and create like a little mountain or a little hill. The original video is a little bit over 10 minutes long. If it's something you'd like to see kind of slowed down, I'd be happy to upload it. Just leave a message in the comments and you know, tell me that's something you'd like to see. These to get lighter as they go up. I want the focus to kind of be on the tree and underneath the tree. I just wanted to strengthen a couple of these limbs. I don't like a perfectly shaped tree, and I like a few leaves to look like they're almost unattached. And here, I'm just strengthening in this one limb. I know you can't see it. And then I'm going to jump down here. And I think we'll attach a swing on it here. I'm just using the side of the tip, the flat part, and then the side again. Normally I would rotate the wood, but since I'm using a camera here, I want to keep that steady for you. Alright, as we kind of wrap this up, as promised, I wanted to show you the other surface I love using.
This cardboard on the back of notebooks is awesome. It takes about the same temperature to burn this cardboard as it does wood. Obviously it's a little bit darker, but it's really a great surface to play on.
So start collecting these and keeping them around just for doing sketches and practice work on.
And this is the portrait I did of my uncle. This is just on the back of a notebook.
If you want to see more, make sure you subscribe and like the video. That's all for now.